want. So we're eating quite a bit. Good deal.
Great sign this morning. Here we are at the 2 a.m. feeding. And the little dude has repositioned himself. And is kicking and quite active this morning. Getting to unlock here and there we go. Yeah. There's some good stuff, dude. I have is the broth off of some chicken cuts in gravy, and he is liking it. It'll give him a little nutrition along with the liquid I've been giving him to keep him hydrated. But he is rolled back to his left side. He was laying facing the other end. It looks like it's his left front paw that is paralyzed now. He keeps fighting, keeps trying.
Man, what a difference a day makes. Come here, dude. Now, I'm trying to get him to lay with his head up so I can feed him. He's wanting to curl around. Nurses can understand this, I guess. When he's unconscious, he's a more cooperative patient.
Things are looking good. Things are looking up. It's a boy. Doesn't seem to be in pain, just frustrated that he can't stand or can't walk, but and he's getting strong, moving. Look at who's having to be caught in, contained now to keep him in his box. We have an active little boy. Think he's a little boy anyway. He is getting movement back in his left side and he is climbing and he is hungry right now. Yes, he is. Ooh. Just recovered completely. We're gonna get on with some feeding. It's a full-time job now to video and contain him. I don't want him to cough again. Much progress. He's living in a cardboard box now and is getting totally spoiled. This is about his third syringe of milk. And he's making turns to his right. He had been only making turns to his left, so I was afraid he had some brain damage. But you can see he readily rights himself. He just wants out of this place now. Right now he just wants more milk. More of that warm milk. Here you go, buddy. Can't figure out how he would prefer to take it. Sometimes he likes standing up. Sometimes he likes to just lay down. I
How's it going to work for you? There you go. Good boy. Good boy. He's... likes to play. So he has lots of energy. Lots of strength now. Just not feeling fractures or anything. I did find some blood in the carrier when I went to clean it up, but it was just small amounts. But as you can see, he's walking, making his left turns now. That left shoulder is working for him. The right one is the one that was the issue. And he can move it, but it occasionally collapses on him like that. He understands this process. Well, you didn't know there were going to be cameras, did you? With the mouth. That's okay.
Open up.
There's new people.
So who are you? I'm more used to one person coming in here feeding me. Now we'll get a party. Got a party. You know there's some chicken broth over there too, don't you? You like to lay down to take that. Pose. Watch. I need some chicken broth the other way. The more smell blood they need, the more liquid.
They don't die.
Go away. This way, thanks.
That's more comfortable.
He's afraid of high places now. I'm gonna be a brown raccoon from this point up. Need a little raccoon parachute, that's what you need. You'll understand. This is the way he likes to get his dog food. Some milk will help keep him hydrated, plus some nutritious. Not too much for his hydration, but it'll relax it. He's lacking me some chicken broth. Here you go, little guy. Speed of the plunger to the tongue. If we start giving him chicken broth, he would, tongue would be going for 2 minutes after I'd taken the syringe out with the chicken broth. Just an involuntary response. Hey, go back. It's his favorite position to eat anyway. Okay. Where's the syringe? He looked at that just and he came out here and he rolled his side again once more.
Nobody's looking at me.
About 9 cc's of this broth. You're on your side. Roll over. Roll over on your side. From you people, I do not recognize your smells.
This 9 cc's he's been. Now this guy smell. Scare me, thank you. Crazy woman. Crazy woman got a camera. Yeah. Crazy woman's got the camera. Yeah. I like this. I like this. Oh yeah, scratch me right there. Right there. Ooh. Yeah, that's good. That's good. Right there, I'm stuck. I'm stuck. I might could eat meat some more chicken. Where are those people? Don't make fun of my leg. Had a hard time lately. Yeah. Had a hard time. Well, what's wrong with this crazy guy? Is he going to drop me again? Still trying to figure out who took me off that roof. Same building.
Get down.
Eat and sleep, that's what he does. Initially, until he could write himself, he was this constant motion. And now that he's able to write himself and walk some, he'll go over and get his corner, curl up, sleep, doing good that. He's learning to calm down. He's making left turns and right turns. But when he starts walking, his front legs collapse, and he ends up doing a little roll.
Mm.
those little nozzles when I put the ball in to water her. Mm-hmm. Need one of those cages that I have to at the other house. This cardboard box is not gonna last him but a couple more days.
Couple more days, that's about all you got in a box. That's all food you get now, buddy. Who's climbing around this morning? Yeah, look who's climbing around this morning. Who's milk? Oh. Trying to climb out. Come here. Come here and see if you can get a front shot.
Hey, soldier.
The boy's getting big, big, big. There you go. He can eat just fine, but he still likes his milk from the syringe. He's already had a bunch this morning. Here you go. As you can see, the spastic kind of convulsive moves have stopped. He's turning left, he's turning right, he's shaking. I've given him flea medication, and so it's not fleas. And now he wants to eat his dog food. Actually, he's getting camera shy. He wants to go find this corner and hide, but you can see his digging motions. Everything's well coordinated, and I'm feeling like 90% certain that I'm going to be able to release him back to the wild. So next step is, after the dogs are all up, to take him outside and let him play in the grass and feed him some dog food out there and get him accustomed to being outside, maybe give him another 2 weeks of growth. But as you can tell, he has put on lots of weight. He's strong and looking good. Just has surprised me at every step of the way. Nice coordinated movements, no falling down anymore. Gets in his water, plays. Coming along nicely.
Going outside? Guess who figured out how to climb out of his box last night?
He said, get me a big boy, strong. is. The dog is missing on my towel. What you doing, buddy? You had to stop.
Going to the potty.
The call of nature there. Dog poop up there.
I think this is what gets you in trouble to begin with.
Get my finger again. It's having such a good time. Yeah, it's having such a good time. Getting lots of exercise.
You guys are in the shadows. Can release himself.
I'm gonna just beat myself.
Like the heart?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, this is the day that soldier gets released. He's leaving this and going into this. He gets to move up to lakefront property. Let him out earlier and he liked it. He readily climbed up in a tree. Wanting to get over there
in the shade and get into the trees. There's lots of bugs and things out here that he can eat. Lots of frogs and lizards. He's moving well. Bit me several times as I was trying to retrieve him when he was out playing in the yard. He tasted freedom and he liked it. So now he's just got to get back in there, get acclimated, find his own food sources. He's got water nearby. And he will be just fine. Found him a tree to climb. It's not very high, but it's a start. He's moving well. Still pretty young, but I was afraid if I kept him caged much longer, he would lose a lot of instinctive behavior and would be even more difficult for him to adapt. So this is an easy place for an animal. Lots of water, lots of food. Dogs are supposed to be kept up, so not a lot of predators out. Good luck, buddy.